stand the smell of orcs.
Yeah, so this is a video about Live Aid Holy Priest and all the calculations he's done in a different video. So in a different video I showed you a spreadsheet, and if you like that spreadsheet, then actually below this video you can have the newest version of the spreadsheet and fill in some numbers, and you can see what effects you have when healing. All right, so to gather data to put in the spreadsheet, you only need two things. You need your plus healing in total, and that means that you have your gear values and the values that you get based on your character stats, the build, add it up and you get a number. So to do that, I had actually a add-on called Holy Stats. That's this little square over here, and it tells me in this case I have a heal bonus of 297 and a crit chance of 18.7% with the gear I'm wearing currently. Right, awesome, this gear. So if I change the gear, and I've added on for that as well, gear equipper, then you can say, well, what if I don't wear my crit gear, but I wear my healing plus gear? So this is all the best healing gear. Well, I didn't make maybe a few concessions, but to have to as much plus gear bonus, in this case 397 and only 12.2% crit chance. Right, so if you want to use these numbers for calculations, then you can use my sheet. The sheet itself is complex, so in the end I will strip the sheet so you can see a lot more numbers. But now for the simplest version of the sheet, let's look at this. All right, so 207, 407, 12.2. That was the stats I just had, and that has an effect. So if I do a flash heal rank 1, then this is the average output plus the crit. If I do my healing gear, then also I crit, but there's more effect of the plus healing gear, so this is the output. Right, okay. And if I do a higher rank, these are the outputs, and you can see that with the crit gear, it is actually the ratio, well, the size of the heal, of course, is getting bigger when the flash heal goes up. But the ratio of mana used and health recovered, that's what this number is representing, that actually is very flat. Coincidentally, because if I change the numbers, you will see changes in these numbers as well. So if I change this, then this will definitely change, as you see over here. Because this is the healing gear, 407 by 12. So only based on the healing gear, when I do a rank 1 flash heal, the mana ratio is a little better and the heals are also a little bit better. With the higher rank, actually, the crit gear outperforms my personal healing gear. So you want to do this for your own character and your gear sets, if you have more gear sets, and you will get numbers as here as well. With the heal, the crit is less performing with the lower rank, and the higher rank it is better performing slightly, but still. And I've got something important to say about that as well. With the greater heal 1 and the greater heal 4, the crit gear outperforms my healing gear. Now, saying that, it not only outperforms it over here in numbers, but it outperforms it actually totally, because every time I crit, I have the inspiration buff giving 25% extra armor, or if you watch this video a couple of months later, and we had an extra update from the software, from the game, then it is 10% damage reduction. That is powerful, especially when you crit as much as I do. And this number can be actually much higher, especially when you have also some world buffs. So crit gear for me is very important at this stage of the game. Maybe if I have more healing gear later, it might change. Well, I'll simply put in the numbers over here and I can decide what is a better idea. Now, knowing this, I said something in the last video about renew and that you better be a druid when you want to use renew. Well, that's partly true. Because if you look at the values of the renews, well, if you only use 40 mana on renew 1, then it is a very high return in mana spent and health created. And with the healing gear, it is even better. And if you look at all these values in the last column, the maximum values, then you see that they run up in my gear to about 6.3 as highest number. And on this side, 6.6. If I look at this list over here, I can see that with the gear, renew rank 4 is just as good, or actually better, than all of the other heals. So I can actually do a lot of renews and say, well, I'm actually doing a good job. I'll probably do some overhealing as well, but I'm doing actually quite a good job keeping the rate up. For tank healing, would the renew also work? Yes, why not? Especially with the higher ones. They're not that bad. 4.8. Well, look at here. 4.2. So it's not that bad. So you can use renew on in your healing rotations as well, if you like. I would then actually just do these ones. For example, just give a lot of rank ones to the warlocks. It's cheap for you. It's valuable for them. Thanks for watching and enjoy the sheet. Just download it from my OneDrive below in the comments. You can see some extra link to do that. Oh, and I almost forgot. It's a piece so you can see the whole sheet. So if you actually just say unhide everything. So I just selected all of the fields. So let's do an unhide. And then it sees all of that, all the data, so the casting time, the mana costs, the penalty on the plus healing given by Blizzard, by the way. So that's just facts. And all these facts, they give all of these other things that you want to see right this